It can surprise many people that they're actually the cause for their own anxiety. What part do you play? Let's look at that today on the show. If you're a subscriber to the show, you'll know that last week I was helping you decide to get better. And so this week, I'm going to help you understand your part in that whole process of self-improvement or self-development. It's not just applicable for people with a high degree of anxiety. You might find today's show is just a good lesson on how to live your life right and to take responsibility for the way you're living it. There's a fun quote in my book, Winning Mindset, that says that being a good brain owner is like being a good dog owner. I did chuckle when I wrote that, but it has proven to be true and has stood out for many people as they've read the book. Now, it's true that your parents did definitely program you from birth, otherwise you wouldn't understand these English words I'm using to communicate with you. They taught you a lot about you, a lot about your family, a lot about life, but you had to accept the lessons and to agree to maintain that truth, or you'd have just been the rebel in your family that goes against the family motto. We stay safe by being afraid! You see, you were defined in part by nature, but there is this component of nurturing that allows you to train your brain to speak a different language if you choose to learn French or Mandarin. If you decide to not learn a foreign language, you can't really blame your parents for having not taught you one. Once upon a time, they were responsible, but today, it's all on you, isn't it? As the grown-up adult you, you are fully responsible for making and maintaining your own psychological states. They could have taught you to be anxious, but if you're continuing to be anxious, that's all on you today. They could have taught you to breathe into your chest instead of your stomach like a healthy baby boy or girl, but if you still do that today, that's on you. Your parents have definitely programmed you and taught you a lot of things, but you have the ability to learn to change, and if you're not doing it, you have to take responsibility for your own failure there, no? It's only a big scary world out there if you agree it's a big scary world out there. If that actually excites you and you feel driven to go out there and adventure, then that's on you, as it should be. We are all responsible for the choices that we make in life. And if you're not making a conscious decision to defy your old programming and become the best version of you possible for you, then your inaction is definitely a message you're sending to yourself. And the best advice that I could give you is, be responsible for your own decisions. Move forwards into a life with purpose. Set a goal for yourself that you can take aim at and make progress on. And don't blame the government, your teachers, or your parents for a less than amazing life. Any substandardness is fully on you, because if you're accepting it, it's the decision that you've made, and you can only blame yourself. Now let's plan a better future for you and start sowing the seeds to make that happen together in today's brief but effective meditation, which as always is not appropriate for you to listen to if you're in the middle of rush hour driving and you have to pay attention to stay alive. As with all meditations, they don't really work if you don't follow the instructions. If you know better, then go and do it your way and don't bother listening. But if you'd like to learn from me, then, if it's safe and appropriate, take a seat. Allow yourself to get really comfortable and take one or two easy breaths before you decide on purpose to close your eyes down so that you can remove all the visual stimuli from the arena of your brain. And as you relax more and more gently and effectively with each and every slow exhale, purposefully releasing the tension in your body and letting yourself get really settled, I invite you to enter the theatre of your imagination. In your mind, you can imagine anything. So in preparation for that, just see how really relaxed you can become. Let go of any holding or any tension. Follow the sound of my voice as you imagine waves of relaxation, softening your body and allowing you to just surrender into this moment, leaving your body out there as your mind goes deeper and deeper into this experience. Imagine walking down 5 steps towards double doors, as 5, relaxing and releasing tension, 4, allowing yourself to really let go as you breathe your way deeper down, 3, simply surrendering to this moment, feeling that relaxation grow within you, as 2, almost there as you see those doors and begin to wonder what you'll experience on the other side as one, you reach the depths of relaxation and slowly open those doors to reveal a theater that you take a step into and find a seat to sit down so that you can observe everything that's about to play out on the front center stage. Rest and relax in your chair, and as you focus on the theater in front of you, imagine what it would be like to see yourself standing front and center stage. Imagine in a moment that you is going to have an anxious thought, and I want you to just observe what happens to that you and what that you does that makes that anxiety worse. Notice, as you can imagine, that anxious thought appearing in the mind of the you on stage. Does the breathing change first, or the bodily tension? Do you notice the fists gripping, or the shortness of breath from the breathing having moved from the abdomen up into the chest? What do you see in the facial expression that begins to alert the body that there's something to be concerned about? Did the message accomplish this, or was it the interpretation of that message by the brain of that you on stage? And what would make this different? Imagine this beginning over again, but this time the you on stage will do something different. How will you continue to breathe in a calm fashion? How will you let go of any tension that begins to build in the body? What do you think they say to themselves that makes the outcome better this time? Imagine being a wonderful director, perfectly guiding that you on stage to do so much better so that their brain can learn from this. Imagine it starting over again, but this time it goes really well. Make all the changes to that performance that you feel is needed in the areas of breathing and bodily tension, or the thoughts that they entertain in their mind. See it beginning again now. Let's see confidence in that face and body. Let things go exactly as you'd like them to go. And then imagine it beginning all over again, but this time, drift into that body and be on stage. Be there in the theatre of your mind as the starring actor playing the role of a lifetime, being absolutely confident, breathing confidently, feeling confident, and thinking confident thoughts. And imagine that happening again now. And see the confidence, feel it within you. And imagine that beginning again now. That's right. You can be given a message that could be concerning, but you can hear that message in a way that's far more appropriate for the you that you're becoming. And every time you do that, the wiring in your brain will continue to change and improve and develop on purpose so that you can become the habit that you'd like to be. For we all are creatures of habit, and your habits can change when you decide to get better. And you understand your part, so now you know the changes that you need to make. Find your seat in the theater and ponder that for a moment as you hear the applause from the crowd around you. You did really well today. Allow your meditation to come to a close as you ponder the learnings and those things that you should hold front and center of your mind today. And then leaving this experience for your unconscious mind to process into your neurology. Simply decide to take one or two or three easy breaths and come all the way back to the body you left in the chair. Opening your eyes now, stretching and smiling, feeling absolutely fantastic, knowing that there is something that you could be doing to get better. Don't you agree? Share a comment today about how you've enjoyed the show or what's been particularly helpful for you. And next week, we'll be moving into your greatness together. As always, like, love and share the show. Make sure you go to worryfreewednesday.show and download 3 free meditations and get some show updates and notifications, the occasional gift in your inbox. And I'll see you next week. Stay confident.
Worry Free Wednesday.